Dear students, so now we are going to discuss about learners with intellectual and learning disabilities. So this is your unit 3. So coming to the objectives of unit 3, the first objective is to identify and differentiate the learners with intellectual and learning disabilities. Second is to discuss how to assess the performance of the learners with intellectual and learning disabilities in the school. Third one is to identify difficulties with respect to their learning characteristics. And last, to explain how to use specific strategies to meet their needs in the school. Coming to the nature of disability. So an intellectual disability, also commonly referred to as a developmental disability among other terms, is simply stated a disability that significantly affects one's ability to learn and use information. It is a disability that is present during childhood and continues throughout one's life. A person who has an intellectual disability is capable of participating effectively in all aspects of daily life, but sometimes requires more assistance than others in learning a task, adapting to changes in tasks and routines, and addressing the many barriers to participation that result from the complexity of our society. So now, what is intellectual disability? Internationally, the definition of mental retardation or intellectual disability has moved away from medical model to rehabilitative model. Current trend is to describe the condition by using functional and educational terms rather than clinical terms. Characteristics of children with intellectual disabilities. So the first characteristic is delays in oral language development. Second, deficits in memory skills. Third, difficulty learning social rules. Fourth, difficulty with problem-solving skills. Fifth, delays in the development of adaptive behaviors such as self-help or self-help care groups or self-care skills. And lastly, lack of social inhibitors. Now coming to some of the assessment tools in Indian context. The first one in this is Madras Developmental Programming System, that is MDPS, NIMH Vocational Assessment and Programming System for Persons with Mental Retardation, that is NIMH VAPS, Behavioral Assessment Scale for Indian Children with Mental Retardation, that is Basic MR, Functional Assessment Checklist for Programming, that is FACP, Upanayan, a program of developmental training of for children with mental retardation, and Portage Guide to Early Education. Coming to the supporting learning of learners with intellectual disabilities, so there are two columns you can see: teaching strategies and description. The first is task analysis. It is a teaching strategy where a task is broken down into simple teaching components and arranged into sequential order. It is a blueprint for instruction or teaching for the teacher by which the learner proceeds to achieve the target goals. Reinforcement, it is the critical component of pragmatic attempt to teach new behavior and to increase occurrence of existing behavior. Reinforcement, the same time it is helpful in mainstreaming appropriate level of the behavior. For example, rewarding a child by saying, "Oh, very good, well done," etc., if he or she does a task correctly. Now coming to modeling. Modeling is teaching through demonstration. It is equally useful for teaching both new behavior and to correct already learned behavior. For example, teaching of dance through modeling. Now some other teaching strategies. So teaching functional academics. functional academics is merely academics made functional, designed to teach skills which allow each student to succeed in real life situations at home, school, work, and in the community. The functional academics curriculum includes functional reading, functional writing, and functional arithmetic. Teaching functional reading. Functional reading is defined as a student's actions or responses resulting from reading printed words. Functional terms is related to application of learned skills in real community settings. Hence, words selected for reading must be such that allows the readers to become independent in community living. Teaching functional writing. One of the important modes of communication is written expression. This demands eye-hand coordination, motor coordination, sense of direction, and recognition of symbols, that is, pictures, letters, numbers, words, punctuations, etc. Some writing tasks require left-to-right orientation in horizontal direction for writing words, whereas some tasks require vertical orientation for writing numbers in arithmetic problems, as in addition or subtraction. Teaching functional arithmetic. Numbers play an important role in our lives. Our communication involves reference to negotiating quantities. Functional mathematics defined as use of mathematics needed for vocational, consumer, social, recreational, and homemaking activities. So that's all in this video. Thank you very much.